Hello, it's Angus here at the Bureau. This is a severe weather update for Wednesday, the 6th of September. And do buckle up. This is a big one. There's a powerful cold front across the southeast, bringing some chilly, windy conditions. One of the most notable storms of the cooler months across Australia. It's been pretty mild through winter, but this is going to be a cold one. So let's start off with the warning areas, which are currently active. These are damaging wind warnings. At the moment, the wind we're looking at is actually a strong northerly flow that comes before the cool wind change. So that's wind down from this direction here across large parts of New South Wales, pushing up into southern Queensland as well as a lot of central Victoria. Lots of areas under the damaging wind at the moment. We could see wind gusts of 90 or 100 kilometres an hour through these areas on Thursday. Now let's put it into a little bit of context and we will see what the weather systems are doing, which is causing such a strong wind flow. We see a front in the southwest moving across southeastern Australia Thursday and into Friday. We also have a low developing along the course of that front, which is going to accelerate the wind. This initial frontal band here, the rain that we see on the map, we're likely to see showers and storms develop along that band. Some of the storms that could be severe, causing damaging wind gusts and the possibility of some large hail, particularly by the time the storms reach the east coast. Behind this frontal change, we're going to see the wind shift direction. It's a much cooler southwesterly wind flow across the southern states, particularly on Friday. Victoria, Tasmania, southern New South Wales are going to see chilly conditions. They're going to see further showers and the possibility of some fairly extensive hail around this part of the country come Friday and maybe first thing on Saturday morning as well, before all of the active weather starts to move out into the Tasman and conditions ease in time for the weekend. A look at the wind in a little bit more detail here. We're looking at the wind slightly elevated actually, just a little bit above the surface, about 1.5 kilometres high. If I just pause it here, we'll see this band of very strong northerlies, very, very warm coming down from the north. Some parts of New South Wales could be 10 degrees above average in terms of their temperature for Thursday. And some of those strong dry winds could kick up some dust through these inland areas. As we play forward on the loop here, we'll see this initial band of northerlies move eastwards, but we're not done with the wind just yet. We get another surge of strong wind, particularly down the south along parts of coastal Victoria, even parts of Tasmania as well. This is going to be a different wind. It's going to be a much, much cooler southwesterly flow. Temperatures are really plummeting when that wind shifts direction. Speaking of cold temperatures and strong wind, it's a good recipe for some snowfall. Has been slim pickings for snow really over the past couple of months, but some fairly extensive falls are forecast for Friday and Saturday. The lowest snow is likely to be across Tasmania, where snow could fall as low as 500 metres, more like 700 metres for Alpine Victoria and 800 or 900 metres for New South Wales, including parts of the central tablelands. The final thing we're going to do here is move out over the water. This is the forecast for swell, and in particular we're looking at some really large waves developing along this coastline here, southern parts of South Australia as well as the southwest coast of Victoria. Damaging swell warnings are possible along this coastal area as we round out the week, with some really large waves expected for most coastal areas all around the southeast of Australia. Finally, it is going to be the marine wind warnings. We've got warnings in place for most of southern Australia, stretching all the way from Perth and southwestern WA on Wednesday, right around the coast to some parts of southern New South Wales. And then Thursday, much the same, but we have got some of these warnings into the next threshold up. Those are our gale warnings. Likely to see more of these on Friday. There it is, lots of weather going on over the course of the next few days. If you want to stay up to date with the latest warnings, you can go here, bomb.gov.au, the Bomb social media, and the Bomb weather app. That is it. We'll see you again tomorrow.